The internet has become, without a doubt, the most revolutionary technological advance of the past century, and has become an integral and defining feature of our society. Whilst the internet has served to connect us across the globe, an age of information and connectivity has created a plethora of avenues for the illegal and subversive sharing of copyright material, in particular the sharing of music, a practice which costs the Australian economy upwards of $900 million annually. The emergence of online file sharing has been seen for some time as a force which has drained profit from the industry and artists. However, as observed throughout Australia and the world, it has also been heralded as a new age of music creation and distribution. NetLoss aims to analyse the effect of internet file sharing, both legal and illegal, and its effect on the industry of music creation and distribution, investigating whether it's still possible for an artist to make a profit in the ever-evolving industry.
One of them things that's kind of like you can't really avoid it, like you can't escape it, like just the internet in general. It's pretty much like killed that part of it. I don't know, it's funny, I don't see the point in like being bitter about it anymore. Like, well, I didn't really in the first place. Like, it sucks, like, you know, them people who, you know, played that song to get it to that number, if they had bought the record for $13, $14, and I'd be high rolling.
Despite the ever-looming threat of internet music piracy in the music market, the digital market has continued to diversify with a marked increase in popularity for subscription services such as Spotify, growing by 51% in recent years. Global revenues from subscription and advertising supported streams now account for 27% of digital revenues, being estimated that more than 28 million people worldwide now pay for a music subscription.
As far as, you know, even like legal methods of listening to our music, like this is Spotify, you know, like that's, you might as well just download it. You know what I mean? For free, like one of our songs had like something like, I don't know, I'll probably be exaggerating, but like over like 100,000 spins. Just a ridiculous amount, you know. And we made $8.
Physical format sales still account for a major proportion of industry revenues, accounting for, again, 51% of all global revenues. This is attributed to the fundamental fact that despite the option to steal from artists free of cost, many people will opt to support their favourite artists by buying both physical and digital copies of their music. In particular, in the recent emergence of the particularly expensive and formerly deemed redundant vinyl format.
Vinyl, if you look after it, you know, I have beautiful records, you know, 60 years old that are still beautiful and sound beautiful. The artwork's fantastic because you've got, you know, I collect record covers just for the artwork. Some you can go to the website and get the digital format, you know, and still have the vinyl. I think it's two different markets, and I think it gives opportunity for people to listen to the bands they like, then go and seek it out at the record stores and buy.
Whilst these statistics bear hope for already established artists and associated businesses who sell music enough to make revenue, it can't be denied that the presence of the internet has caused irreconcilable damage to the music industry and made redundant the old model of recording and distribution, begging the question as to how the presence of the internet benefited independent bands.
Now anyone can be, you know, anyone can be their own, like, label. It meant that while we were still young and we're making, I guess, like, the baby steps, you know, like, the first EP we did, that would just be sitting at, like, you know, a couple of local music stores. You know, it was a way for people to find our music and download it and, you know, purchase it, like, from, like, all around, like, the country or the world, you know. Releases like that wouldn't have, like, sold or, like, wouldn't have, you know, covered as much ground if it wasn't for the internet.
As it stands, it's difficult to say whether the benefits afforded by the internet will ever outweigh the undeniable damage that it has caused to music profits. The only thing certain is that the internet is here to stay. The artists and industry will have to adapt in order to remain viable in the modern era.